From New York, in the little theater on 44th Street, just west of Broadway, it's time for music, fun, and excitement with your favorite recording artist and your Saturday night host, Dick Clark.
Who likes Beech-Nut? We like Beech-Nut.
Beech-Nut Show with...
Hi, how are you all? Nice to have you all here. You know, I got used to the blackboard. We're making finish that motion picture. They got me cast as a teacher. I think this is carrying things a little far, but we got talking about things the other day, and as you know, this show has been built around records for a long time. And that roughly is the shape of a 45 RPM record. If they make them that way, we're all in trouble. But we took the circle tonight and the various things that you could do with a round shape like this and use that as kind of the background of everything. And if you take it and you tack circles together like this, you get millions. And the fellas who made the records tonight, outside of being most of them very startlingly handsome, have sold millions and millions of records altogether. They've all got a batch full of hits. You girls, strap yourselves in for this first fella, because he was here 5 or 6 weeks ago with a song that was on the rise. It's hit the top now. It's a fantastic thing. If I Had a Girl. Here's Rod Lauren.
Give to her all my life. I would live for her if I had a girl, a little girl like you. Kisses sweet, arms that tremble to hold her tight. I would bring to her every night if I had a girl, a little. I've seen your face and I've touched your hair. I've dreamed you a thousand times. Oh, I'd know you anywhere. You're the one, you're an angel that heaven sent. And forever I'd be content if I had a girl, a little girl like you. I've seen your face and I've touched your hair. I've dreamed you a thousand times. Oh, I know you anywhere. You're the one, you're an angel that heaven sent. And forever I'd be content if I had a girl, a little girl like you, a little girl like you, a little girl like you.
Oh, he's a good-looking rascal, isn't he?
Wow.
Let me ask you, what is your first name?
Sonia.
Sonia, there is a very, very handsome young man. Now, looks are certainly not everything in the world, but if you were picking your dream man, what would he look like?
Tall, blonde hair, dark, I don't know.
Tall, blonde hair, and he'd be dark. Mm-hmm. For some reason, it seems to be a little confusion. Do you have a boyfriend?
No.
Well, I was going to say, and you ask your girls, you have a boyfriend, what's he like? He's short, and he's got black hair, and so forth. No, I guess it doesn't matter really what you look like, it's what's inside. But here is a man who has a great deal inside, and on the outside, he's pretty easy to take. He's come a long, long way from the land of beautiful women and flowers and music and so forth. If you will give him an exceptionally nice, warm greeting, he sings Bad Boy. Ladies and gentlemen, here's Robin Luke.
Even dear old dad, when he gets mad, says I'm a bad boy.
Garth, can you run up the curtain here and show the folks my automobile and my good-looking girlfriend here? Yeah, there she is. Hello, sweetie. Put your face up so everybody can see. There's nothing like a good-looking automobile and a good-looking gal, and there you are. This, incidentally, is one of the prizes in our Beech-Nut contest. I'd like to tell you about the movie premiere contest and how it operates and how maybe you could win yourself this automobile. First thing you do is have a look at this film clip of the some of the film that we took last August when we were out in Hollywood shooting Because They're Young. This was a day when we were all eating in a high school cafeteria of Hoover High School in Glendale, California. The gal there, incidentally, is Victoria Shaw, and she plays my girlfriend in the movie. Very, very nice gal. There's a fellow you know, Jimmy Darren, who makes a guest appearance in the motion picture, and all in all, it promises to be very exciting. It's taken a while to get it together, and its release date will be around Easter time. And the Beech-Nut people have done something very, very nice. They're throwing a great big gala festive evening for me and a dinner, and they said, you invite some of your Hollywood friends and get some of the stars and the cast there, and I would like very much to invite you to come along to have dinner with us and then go to the premiere, which should be fun. I don't want you to be lonely, so the Beech-Nut people have provided 100 free tickets to the world premiere of Because They're Young, and so that you'll feel at home. They will stage the world premiere of the motion picture in your own hometown with all of the lights and the excitement and the stars and the action and everything. And in addition to that, so that you remember us year-round, the grand prize winner will also receive a beautiful Esther Williams living swimming pool, complete with an exclusive solar roof. This thing has a roof on it. You can swim in the pool all year round. And for those of you who would like something extra special nice for second prize, the Triumph TR3, America's favorite sports car. Can you visualize yourself driving to school in this? Oh, boy. Well, that's the second prize. In addition, there are 20 third prizes, such as this set right here, the Kodak movie outfit, complete with the Brownie turret camera and the fully automatic Kodak Showtime projector. That, of course, is the third prize. There are 50 fourth prizes, 50 VM self-contained portable hi-fi sets. Hi-fi because the VM flips its lid and becomes a complete stereo system. Now, those are 50 prizes. There are 75 fifth place prizes, 75 Channel Master transistor radios, the transistor that gives you power and performance. That's the fifth prize. And 1,000 sixth place prizes, 1,000 Dance with Dick Clark volume number 2 albums. That makes a total of 1,147 prizes. Junie, thank you. And the easiest thing in the world is all you have to do is name my girlfriend here. Now, she plays a very small part in the motion picture, and she was kind of our movie mascot. And I would imagine you probably got a couple of names for her, if you could think of it. You jot her name on a piece of paper, and along with 5 outside pack wrappers from any Beech-Nut chewing gum, you send them along to Movie Contest, Box 11, New York 46, New York. And if you can think of more than one name for her, send them along each time with the 5 outside pack wrappers. And give us an idea. You can enter as many times as you want. And the address is Movie Contest, Box 11, New York 46, New York. They must be postmarked by February 21st, and we have to receive them before February 26th. Let me repeat the address twice. Movie Contest, Box 11, New York 46, New York. That's Movie Contest, Box 11, New York 46, New York. Okay? Now, let me introduce now a man who is probably one of the most dynamic young performers you'll find around. He's got one of the swingin'est records of the day, a thing called Handyman. Ladies and gentlemen, Jimmy Jones!
The love and I'm no fool. I fix broken hearts. I know I really can.
Thank you, Jimmy, very much. It's a swinger. I want to try an experiment with you. This is how I've often wondered how people tell stories to one another and what it finally ends up. I would like to tell you something, and if you will turn and tell it to the next man, and you, sir, turn and tell it to the next gal, and so forth, and we'll see what it ends up. I asked that young lady over there what her ideal boyfriend was. Let me tell you what my ideal girlfriend would be. We'll tell the folks at home, and as a pass down, we'll see what it ends up on the other side. All right, you ready to listen now? Now you tell it to the fella next to you, nibbling on his ear there. Now what's that? You tell it to the gal next to you. Gil, will you tell the folks at home what they're whispering now?
Dick's ideal girl is 5 feet tall, with blue eyes, small feet, cherry lips, and pierced ears.
Pick this up. Be very interesting to see what kind of a girl I'm going to end up with. Gil, once again, you just tell the folks at home for a second what they passed along the line, will you?
What's Dick's girl ideal like? Girl is 5 feet tall with blue eyes, small feet, cherry lips, and pierced ears.
Wait, you tell me, what does my gal look like?
5 feet two and has pierced ears.
Well, that's close. That's all that remained of my ideal dream girl is 5 feet tall, with blue eyes, small feet, cherry lips, and pierced ears. The poor girl only ended up 5 feet two with pierced ears. Hey, yeah, she's a beauty, yeah. You know, it's a rare thing when a song reaches the top 10 sellers and is a ballad and reaches there in a very short length of time. This is one of the most stirring ballads of the day. It's done by a man whose family's been making music for years and years. He is the younger brother of the famous Dinning sisters. Ladies and gentlemen, the song is called Teen Angel. Here is Mark Dinning.
Teen Angel, Teen Angel, Teen Angel. That fateful night, the car was stalled upon the railroad track. I pulled you out and we were safe, but you went running back. Teen Angel, can you hear me? Teen Angel, can you see me? Are you so you were looking for that took your life that night? They said they found my high school ring clutched in your fingers tight. Teen Angel, can you hear me? Just sweet 16, and now you're gone. They've taken you away. I'll never kiss your lips again. They buried you today. Teen Angel, can you hear me?
Are we, by any chance, keeping you up, old buddy?
I was holding your hand here.
Who's that over there behind George? It's a beautiful face, isn't it? You know, this is a funny thing. This gal won't sit down. She's got too much to fold up to sit down. She always lies then. Have we kept you up past bedtime, old buddy? See if you can think up a name for her. She's the sweetest old pooch I think I ever ran into. She's heavy, though. She weighs it to smile for mother now. All right, you stay tight. Be nice. Yeah. This fella was scheduled to be with us about a couple of weeks ago, and we had a tremendous fog situation, so he was unable to fly in from Detroit, and so we made a later date, and in the meantime, the song just got bigger and bigger, so we're tickled to death to have him here with a thing called What in the World's Come On to You?
What in the world's come over you? Seems we never get along. Change your mind. If you do, I'll still be here waiting, longing for you. All my life I've loved you so. Never dreamed I'd miss you so. It's just not right. Oh, what in the world's come over you? Could you ever change your mind? If you do, I'll still be here waiting, longing for you.
Nice to have you back again. You know, we were talking before, I got the biggest kick out. Unfortunately, you couldn't see, there was a gal back there with binoculars, you know, so you're only about 5 feet away, studying every move and so forth. We were talking about zeros before. If you were to tack all the zeros together and put a few numbers in front of them, you would come up with a figure somewhat over 12 million records. Now, 12 million records is not to be sneezed at in any man's language. These men have sold over 12 million records.
Ladies and gentlemen, the Everly Brothers.
I bless the day I found you. I want to stay around you, and so I beg you, let it be me.
Thank you, gentlemen. Let it be me. It's headed toward the top ten. Let's look at that top ten. Listen, hold number ten because it's number new. Yes, it's the big hurt is number nine. Number eight is Not 1 Minute More. Number seven is New. We'll hold that. Number six is Where or When. Number five, Pretty Blue Eyes. Number four, Way Down Yonder. Number three, Gold Jimmy Go. Number two, Why, and Running Bear. Well, let's see, one through six. Let's try number ten.
Should I hang up?
That's by Jim Reeves. 10, 9, 8. You've already heard number 7. That's Teen Angel. And here is the song that was in the top 10 for quite a while. Let's bring him back to Do Till I Kissed You. The Everly Brothers.
Never felt like this until I kissed you. Until I kissed ya. Never had you on my mind. Now you're there all the time. Never knew what I missed till I kissed ya. Uh-huh, I kissed ya. Oh yeah, things have really changed since I kissed ya. Now that I kissed ya. Oh yeah.
Bill and Don Everly, the Everly Brothers. Gentlemen, thank you. Nice to have you back again. Incidentally, in the meantime, you try to think of a name for my friend here. As many names as you want, along with 5 outside pack wrappers from any beech nut gum. You send them along, and who knows, you may win yourself that swimming pool or the world premiere of Because They're Young in Your Own Hometown, or the automobile or one of the other prizes. The address is Movie Contest, Box 11, New York, 46, New York. Nice to have you with us tonight. My dear, you're gonna join us over here? All righty. Next week... Got more friends, no less. Next week, our special guest will be Mitzi Gaynor, Stonewall Jackson, D. Clark. The Passions will be here. The Fireballs also. And Lloyd Price will be joining us again. Thank you very, very, very much for coming by, if you can. Can we get everybody out to say goodnight for tonight? Dick Clark. Good night.
Dick Clark and the Beech-Nut Show have been brought to you by Beech-Nut Spearmint, the gum that's flavorific. Reach for Beech-Nut and join us again next week, same time, same place, when we'll be swinging your way with Dick Clark and the Beech-Nut Show. Join the March of Dimes. Your generosity for the Mother's March volunteer calls will help support this fine cause. This has been a Drexel television production in association with the American Broadcasting Television Network.
See the vivid contrast between ancient and modern Greece on John Gunther's High Road, next on the ABC Television Network.